The Lakers have a really busy offseason, and everyone is eagerly waiting for them to hit the floor, so we can start evaluating what kind of team this is. There's a lot of star power, but many question whether this squad has enough depth and quality to make a run. It is worth noting, however, that the Lakers were also doubting 2 years ago and ended up winning it all. So with all that in mind, let's take a look at the Rondo deal, how that affected Isiah Thomas, plus other news around the league. Rajon Rondo joins the Lakers. Rajon Rondo re-signs with the Lakers again, having left the squad to sign with the Hawks after LA won the championship 2 seasons ago. After agreeing to a buyout with the Grizzlies this offseason, it seemed pretty clear that a return to the Lakers was on the cards. But how does this affect the cap salary? Minimally, Rondo agreed to a pretty team-friendly deal of $2.6 million and immediately became a valuable player coming off the bench for LA. His playmaking is a perfect counter for Russell Westbrook's aggressive play style, and he should be able to help them in that regard. The only issue here is one that analysts and fans have been talking about all offseason. What will the spacing look like with Westbrook and Rondo both being below average three-point shooters, even if Rondo had a great stretch 2 years ago in the playoffs? Even more interesting about this deal is that it invited potential beef between the two guards, especially given that they can't really share the floor, and so one will start over the other. Rondo and Westbrook have had some jabs levied at one another, and so now we will have to see if they can bury the hatchet as they work toward a mutual goal of winning a championship. How does Rondo and the team feel about the move? Rondo played a huge part in their playoff run 2 years ago, but this move feels like a bit of a head-scratcher on paper. This roster is very different from the one that took the court the last time Rondo wore a Lakers jersey, especially in that backcourt. For Rajon, however, the decision was as easy as wanting to have a parade this time if they win. Since the pandemic halted those plans last time he hoisted the Larry O'Brien trophy, Rondo has a chance to have a Jared Dudley-type role on the team, maybe with a little more playing time, but should younger players embrace it, Rondo has a ton of high-level basketball experience and a few finals runs under his belt. How do Westbrook and Rondo fit together? Rondo is the ultimate tactician, while Russell Westbrook is the definition of a go-hard 100% type of guy. Both have had their issues. With Russ, it's that he often can play out of control and take some ill-advised shots. Rondo's floor is higher than Russell's, but his ceiling is much lower. I wouldn't be surprised if the debate on which one of them is best fit to start rages on deep into the year, and should figure to be a key storyline throughout the season. Can Russell Westbrook lead the offense? Can Rajon Rondo do enough to justify hefty minutes? We'll have to wait to find out, but I can't wait to see how things pan out, especially given their history of being less than cordial with each other. What about Isiah Thomas? Any chances of a potential Lakers run for Isiah Thomas, at least as the roster currently stands, seem slim at this point. Rondo effectively cancels out Thomas's role as backup point guard, and it wouldn't make sense for the Lakers to sign a player for $2.6 million just to be the third-string point guard. Isiah Thomas has always been tremendous in the pick-and-roll game, as well as creating his own shots, but has struggled defensively at his size, which could have been the reason that bringing back Rondo appealed to them a little bit more. Many fans in LA wanted to see the former MVP candidate get another shot to prove his worth in LA, especially with how effective of a shooter he once was, could help stretch the floor. Sadly, it doesn't seem to be in the cards, although things for Isiah seem to be looking up as he works out with a few other NBA teams, and it seems he's most closely linked to a move to the Dallas Mavericks right now, a team that might have better use for the beloved player anyways. DeAndre Jordan gets bought out, and looks to sign with the Lakers. In other news, it seems that DeAndre Jordan is going to be wearing a different jersey this season, which from an outside perspective seems strange. Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving lobbied for the player to join them 2 seasons ago, but something must have changed, because he was traded to the Pistons along with 4 second-round picks for a package that boasts Jahlil Okafor as the major player in the deal. The Pistons are apparently close to a buyout that's going to save Brooklyn about $47 million, and will leave DeAndre Jordan a free agent. Only about 2 hours after that deal was done, ESPN reported that Jordan is currently waiting to clear waivers and intends to sign with the LA Lakers. I have to say that this feels like a good deal. as DeAndre Jordan's length and athleticism brings to mind the team from 2 years ago with JaVale McGee and Dwight Howard. This current roster seems ready to defend the rim with plenty of talent at the 4 and 5 position. How does this deal help the Lakers, though? What this deal really does is help the depth on an already deep Lakers team, something that they struggled with last season. The Lakers may have one of the deepest center groups that the league has seen in a while, with Marc Gasol, Dwight Howard, and now DeAndre Jordan. The age factor becomes slightly less worrying than it was even a few days ago, and it is by no means a guarantee that the Spaniard Gasol will return at all. What about Marc Gasol? The future with Marc Gasol seems to be murky at best. After an up-and-down season that involved losing his spot to Andre Drummond and some dip in his play, the center returned from the Tokyo Olympics confirming that he would play and honor the last year of his contract. But now something must have changed between then and now, because he's now declaring his status as not a lock for the season. This is what opened the door for the DeAndre Jordan deal to happen at all, and why it most likely means that the Lakers also don't know what Gasol's intentions are. If Mark was on the fence about returning to the team, he probably isn't anymore after seeing firsthand last year that his spot in the rotation is not guaranteed. Potential trades around the league, and if the Lakers have a chance at any of them. The NBA is a league that is never quiet, and right now there are a few star players currently on the verge of a potential trade. Laker fans are familiar with the Bradley Beal situation closely by now, but it doesn't seem like the Wizards are any closer to trading their superstar than they were when the season ended. They recently revamped their roster with the package the Lakers gave them for Westbrook, making it increasingly unlikely that Beal is going to move before he sees if there's anything salvageable in Washington. On the flip side of things, the Ben Simmons situation has quickly heated up to the point where it seems to be an if not, but when situation over his departure in Philly. Ben Simmons refuses to report to camp. Ben Simmons has finally spoken publicly about a situation we knew was coming, engineering his departure from Philadelphia. Since he decided to pass out of a wide-open dunk in Game 7 that essentially ended their playoff run. As soon as their season ended, rumors of Ben leaving the team grew, but at the same time, his value had dipped, and it became clear that he has some serious postseason issues. This has created a strange situation where the 76ers are forced to ask for a large return package in order to stay competitive with Joel Embiid. All the while, teams don't really believe in Ben Simmons' upside as they once did. Where could Ben Simmons end up? Ben Simmons will most likely have to settle for a team that may not have that much upside, such as the Timberwolves or Kings. Unfortunately, these teams have little to offer the Sixers if they want to try and improve their team for this season. The other issue is that teams have no real incentive to over-ask for Simmons, since it seems as if things are only getting worse within the team as he publicly asks out of the team. It's not unheard of for things to end positively for the team, like the Rockets being able to get a huge return for James Harden despite him not attending camp and asking for a trade, but it's hard to argue that Ben Simmons and Harden have the same kind of value right now too. And with that, it wraps up the video. Thanks for watching.